Hello everybody, I am ToucanDesigns and today I will be teaching you guys how to use the almighty Pentool. The Pentool is a very, very important tool for graphic designers. You can make a lot of awesome stuff with the Pentool, and especially if you're making logo designs, the Pentool is just about the only way to go if you want to make your life a ton easier. Now, if you stick around to the whole video, I'll be teaching you guys how to use the Pentool. And I will actually be giving you guys an example on how the Pentool is used. I'll have an example at the end where I use the techniques we learned and we apply it to actually making the Batman logo. So with that being said, hopefully you guys stick around through the whole video. I plan to keep it short and sweet. So let's get into it. Once you have the Pentool selected, it's in the tools bar. You just click it and you have it selected. What you're going to do is let's do 1 point. We have 1 point, a dot will appear. Let's have 2 points and a line will appear. That's awesome. Now we're done. No, I'm just kidding. So we have a line. That's cool. Now, if you want to undo that line, what we can do is, or if you want to undo this point, what we do is Control Z and it will get rid of that point. If you want to get rid of this point, Control Alt Z to undo both of it. All right, so we have this point. Now we want to curve the points. Or let's make a straight line first. To make a straight line, all you have to do is click Shift. You already have your first point. Click another place to make your second point. Now you have a straight line. Holding Shift makes straight lines, or diagonally you can do it. So instead of going straight down, let's go diagonal. There you go. Up, side. As you can see, I kind of bent that one. All right, so Control Alt Z is to undo the previous points. Now let's make a curved line. So make 2 points, and before you let go of the second point, you click and hold and you drag, and it'll make the two anchor points appear. Now you can, let's make a little smile right here. There you go. So you have this nice little curve. That's awesome. Now let's say you want to move this anchor point. You want to make a frowny face. You do Control, and then you click on one of the anchor points, and you move them. There you go. Oh, it's sad. You can make it happy again. Sad. You can make it this. You can make it that. Whatever you want. But let's say you only want to move one. All you have to do is click Alt and drag down. As you can see, you can still make the faces, but you're only moving one anchor point, so the rest of the points will not be disturbed. So let's say we want this point to be like this, but we want this point to go straight down instead of curve somewhere else. There you go. We have this straight line going across this, as you can see. Now that's cool, that's cool. What else can we do? Now we can obviously make different shapes. So let's make this shape, and we can right click to make a selection. You do make selection. Boom. Okay. Now you have this selection. You can either bucket fill or whatever you want to do. You can also, to get rid of these lines you've created, all you have to do is just click escape and then it's gone. All right, cool. That's basically what you need to know. Let's make the Batman logo. So what we want to do is, let's lower the opacity on this. This is just for practice. I don't condone whatever you do with the Pentool, but you shouldn't be copying other people's work, especially tracing over it. But this is for learning purposes, and it's a really good way to practice. So let's do the Batman symbol. All right, so we're going to make a curve, as you can see. Here we go. We're using the anchor points to match up the line with their line they have. So you can do this with this as well. All right, we can move this anchor point back a little bit so it doesn't shoot far away. It goes a little bit closer in, as you can see. So here we go. We can move it a little bit to kind of match up with the lines. So we don't need to make it perfect in one go, but I just want, see, as you can see, like, we haven't moved this anchor point, so it's going to shoot all the way up, but we don't want that, so we're going to Alt and drag this anchor point down a little bit. You can make it go into this direction. See, whatever direction this points to, that'll make it straight. If you want to make a, you know, straight corner, that's what you would do. So now you're going to drag to make this little bump right here. And then let's move this anchor point so it goes this way when we click on the next point. There you go. Make that one big curve by clicking and holding and dragging. Awesome. Now, as you can see, this one actually looks pretty good. If we just click on it like this, just move it a little bit. Let's get this, and we want it to shoot this way. So we grab it, and we move it this way. Then we can do that nice big curve. Okay, so I don't want to do this whole Batman logo because it'll take a really long time. I suggest you guys practicing and messing around with the pen tool and getting really familiar with it, because the pen tool is truly amazing. And if you learn how to use it, it can save your life. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed. I know I haven't been uploading, things have came up, but hopefully now I'll be able to upload on a daily basis, especially now that it's winter break. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you've learned something, leave a like. And if you still have questions, comment down below. Thank you guys so much. We hit 50 subscribers, which is crazy. It's been, you know, a couple of, this channel's only been up for maybe a month. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out. Bye.